The FDA ordered all U.S. blood banks to test for the Zika virus. Here on the Suncoast, many blood banks have already been testing for Zika, and they still encourage donors to give blood. SNN's Ben Bobick has more.
The FDA may be requiring all U.S. blood banks to test for the Zika virus, but donors shouldn't be too worried before deciding to give blood.
Donors will not see much change in the way that the blood collection process is handled. They do have to sign an extra permission slip for us to test them for Zika, and we do have to collect one extra test tube of blood to be tested for the Zika virus.
Some small blood banks and hospitals who collect their own blood will now have to test for the virus. To ensure the health and safety of blood donors, working together is now more important than ever.
It's even more important for us to have extra blood supplies on hand so that we can help others, not just our community, but the state as a whole. And the blood banks do work together to make sure that nobody loses their lives because there's a shortage of blood products.
On top of working with one another, blood banks have been going the extra mile using new technology.
We even have taken extra measures with pathogen reduction, which is a new technology that flushes all viruses, pathogens, bacteria out of platelets. So the platelet supply in our community is safer than ever.
In case you were wondering what blood banks do when they test your blood for Zika, they're actually a main supplier to researchers in order to get a vaccine to stabilize the virus.
So with every unit of blood that is tested for Zika, hopefully that gets us one step closer to finding an inoculation to prevent the illness in the future.
Reporting in Sarasota County, Ben Bobick, SNN, the Suncoast News Network.
The Suncoast Community's Blood Bank has extended their hours recently in light of the impending storms this weekend. They encourage anyone to stop by and donate.